You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Challenge us at Wexford Insurances, 0818 31 30 30.
I'm now joined in studio by the founder of DoneDeal, Fred Karlsson. Well, Fred, you might start by telling me a bit about your own background, please.
I'm Swedish originally, but I'm married to a lovely Wexford lady. We live in Wexford town. And I came over to Dublin, to Ireland first in 97, just out of college. I was big into IT. I've always been programming computers. I started writing computer games together with a friend when I was 14. And when you came out of college and you were looking for an IT job in 97, the place to be was Dublin. So I came over here. My plan was to be here for 6 months, but I ended up liking Dublin so much, I ended up staying for 3 years, and I met my wife-to-be. So we ended up going to Australia for a year. We went back to Sweden for 3 years. And then we came back to Ireland in end of 2004. And that's where the idea for DoneDeal came up. Because what happened was we lived in Sweden, and Sweden at the time was a few years ahead of Ireland when it comes to internet usage at home. Then we came to Ireland, where people were just about starting to use the internet much more at home. And we saw an opportunity, because when we left Sweden, we used a similar site to DoneDeal to sell all our furniture and all our stuff in Sweden to get rid of it, which was fantastic. It was so handy. You put up your stuff, you take a few photos, advertise it on the site, and it's sold within half an hour, and you get rid of it, and you have money in your hand. Brilliant. So when we came to Ireland, we realized that Ireland still didn't have a great website for buying and selling stuff online. It was all about the paper still, the small little ads at the back of the paper. And, you know, when you tried to read these ones, it was 20 words and it said blue three-seater sofa. And you have no idea what that sofa looks like. So we said that here's an opportunity. In 5 years' time, there will be one website in Ireland that is the dominant website for buying and selling, the main player for buying and selling stuff online. And we said, maybe that could be us.
DoneDeal has been a great success story for County Wexford and across the country. Lots of people forget that every big business started small. What were the first steps you took to start the business?
We launched the website in June 2005, a few months after we came back from Sweden. And at the time, both myself and my wife had a background in IT. So we developed the website ourselves. We wrote it in the evenings and the weekends. We had our normal daytime jobs to keep us going. And we kept it that way for a year and a half. So we kept our daytime jobs, and we worked on DoneDeal in the evenings and the weekends for a year and a half. And it was great because it gave us the opportunity to grow the website without taking in investors or loans or anything like that. Because we could use our salaries to pay for some of the marketing and grow the business from that. And what happened was, after a year and a half, I went full time with the website. And suddenly, instead of just sitting at home in the evenings and the weekends writing stuff for DoneDeal and working on the business, I was sitting at home all day, staring into a wall. We had set up a little home office, and it was a tough time when you don't really know what to do. You're on your own. You have no one to bounce ideas off. It's the tea breaks are fairly boring. Mm. You know, you've heard the jokes before. You tell the same joke to yourself over and over again. And but what we did was, my wife is a great person for organizing stuff. So what we did was, we had weekly reviews. Every Saturday morning, we go down to the local cafe and have breakfast, and she would basically be the manager, and I would tell her what I'd been working on during the week and what I was going to do next week. And she'd go, oh, I think you should focus on this instead. And I go, no, I know exactly what I should be doing, and this is the most important thing. And eventually, when we talk it back and forth, of course, she was right. Yeah. And it was great to have, you know, someone that could help at least keep the focus, because when you're really caught up in a business, you kind of have what you call the flap for the eyes. You don't really, you get tunnel vision. You kind of sometimes miss the big picture. You get caught up in the small details and forget about the big picture. So that was great to have my wife as a sounding board. A year after I went full-time with DoneDeal, she started full-time as well. So suddenly the two of us sat at home staring at each other across the table, wondering, what are we doing here? I don't know, I have no idea, you tell me. And it was a great time. You know, it's a challenge to spend 24-7 with your wife, but it's also a great opportunity. It was really, really, I think we really worked well together. We made sure to split up the work very clearly, what was her work and what was my work, because I'm very stubborn and so is my wife. So we had to make sure that the borders were quite clear. So she was in charge of marketing and I was in charge of the technical parts.
What was the big breakthrough moment for DoneDeal?
There's been a bunch of them. It's very difficult to pick one. Because the business, it's been very steady growth from day one. It's been growing by 5 to 10% every month, which is fantastic. But when you're growing 5 to 10% in the early days, when you have very few people on the site, it's still not very impressive. It's really after 4 or 5 years when the numbers were going from a couple of 100,000 up to a bunch of 100,000 or 2 million people coming to the website. That was a real breakthrough. Another big breakthrough for us was a year after we launched the website in June 2006, we introduced payments on the website. Up until then, when we launched the website, it was free to advertise on the site. You had to do that because to get people into the website. We knew from the start that that wasn't sustainable because we have to make some money to pay our staff. We have to make money to advertise even the website, to grow it, to get people onto the site. So we knew there was always a plan to charge for the ads. And after a year, we were big enough to start charging for the ads. That was fantastic. It didn't make us a lot of money, but we got a couple of hundred euros in every month and that we could put straight into marketing. So that was a great feeling.
It couldn't have all been plain sailing all the way along. Tell me about some of the challenges that you had to overcome.
Well, when you come into business and you've been programming computer for all your life, that was a big challenge to me to start thinking business-wise. Because when you're a techie person like me, everything is black or white. That's it. It's either it works or it doesn't work. Life is very simple that way. In business, everything is much more grey. It's about, yeah, this might work, or this might work better, or this might work even better. But no one really knows, especially when it comes to marketing. Marketing is a tricky one because it's very difficult to track exactly what is happening. Online, it's a little bit easier to track, but still there's areas that you can't track exactly everything that you want to do. So that was a big challenge, and that's where the mentoring from the County Enterprise Board came in to help us. We got in touch with marketing people to help us understand how the marketing should be done and what works and what doesn't work. And also a great business person there who helped us understand, you know, how do we grow the business and what's important in the business. Another challenge was when you take on staff, it's a big step to go from working just for yourself or just working with my wife sitting in one room to taking on the first person, the first employee, because we felt at the time we had to get an office because we didn't really feel fair on the first employee, Donna, to come and sit in our house. That would feel kind of weird. So we said, no, we have to get an office, and then we have to get set up with a PAYE, PRSI. We have to get contracts in place. We have to have health and safety. There was a lot of these, you know, administration things that we never really thought about before. And that took a while to get around. But again, through a mentor that we had through the County Enterprise Board, we could get help with that. So that was great.
Did any of the competitors along the way cause any real major threat to DoneDeal?
Yes. Yeah, of course. I mean, we were lucky in a way that our competitors at the time, one of the competitors was Gumtree, which is a UK company. And we were lucky that they never really focused on Ireland at the time. They were quite big and they had quite a lot of people on their website. But they put all their effort into UK and never really into Ireland. So they never really grew. So their numbers were flat for years while our numbers were growing. And if they had decided to focus on Ireland, I'm sure that in the early days they could have blown us out of the water straight away. Another competitor had big problems with their management turnover. There was something going on there that some manager was fired and he wasn't happy about it, and they were suing each other and stuff like that. And that takes a lot of focus from the business. So for us, that was great. You know, it was obviously a very unfortunate situation for that manager and the people involved in it. It's not a great situation to be in. But from our point of view, that was great because we could grow without anyone really taking notice. I think as well it helped the fact that DoneDeal kind of grew from the countryside. It took us years before we were well established in Dublin. It's only the last maybe 2 years and maybe even the last year that we are reaching everyone in Dublin as well. It was a good few years there where everyone, when you met them in the countryside, they knew about DoneDeal. But when you talk to Dublin people, they said they have no idea. So that helped us again because our competitors were based in Dublin. So they probably didn't notice us. And we managed to grow very big and very substantial before they actually picked up on what was happening.
What would you say the one key strategy was that you used to grow the numbers coming through DoneDeal?
Actually, there's two strategies. Our traffic grew from two sources. The first source was word of mouth. That was 50%. And that was basically, when you go to DoneDeal, and a lot of it was the animal section. If you go to DoneDeal and look in the dog section, you see a lot of very, very cute dogs and pups. And if you see that, you're going to send those cute pups, photos of those cute pups to your friends. And you're going to tell them, hang on, you have to go and look at DoneDeal, look at these cute ones. You're not looking to buy a dog, but you're just looking to look at cute pups. And that's a great viral marketing, worked really, really well for us. But it also worked across all the other sections. So for example, someone sees a car on the site with that is really cheap, they tell their friends. Or a car that is really expensive, they tell their friends. Or they see a car that has really cool go faster stripes, they tell their friends. Or a cool motorbike, anything that is just a little bit different. And it's all about the photos. Because people love the photos, they can see what's happening and they can talk about the photos with their friends. So that was 50% coming from word of mouth. The other 50% was basically Google. Both as paid advertising and free advertising. So Google was a great part of our success. And we tried different marketing in the early days and we never really got it to work. I mean, Google worked really well. If you're a techie person, Google advertising is very handy because it's all about maths, it's all about stats, it's all about numbers. So you can get started very easily and you can tweak your numbers and get great value out of it. But you have to make sure, we worked very hard to make sure that we only did the whatever was necessary in paid advertising, and we put a lot of focus into turning that paid advertising into free advertising, i.e. coming up for free in Google.
Is it true to say as well that you took a sector-specific growth strategy?
Yes and no. We were probably a bit lucky, because when we moved over from Sweden, we had used a similar site in Sweden to sell our furniture. So I was absolutely 100% convinced that the first section to take off in Ireland would be furniture. Because, of course, everyone wants to buy furniture, I reckoned, because that's what I wanted to buy. Now, having said that, this is 2005. Ireland is booming. Everything is booming. Everything is just going up. There was no one who had interest in buying second-hand furniture. If you were buying new furniture, you didn't want to sell the second-hand furniture. You threw it out, or you gave it to charity, or you just dumped it, or whatever. So you couldn't be seen with second-hand furniture at the time in Ireland. So that section never really took off in the early days. Now, having said that, the last few years, that section is doing really, really well. So things have obviously changed. But the first section to actually take off was pups, or was dogs. And again, it came from, there was no other site in Ireland who did animals at the time or did dogs with big photos like we did at the time. So people started talking about it. And a lot of people came to the website to look at the dogs. They weren't interested in buying a dog. But they would go in, they would come there to look at the dogs. And then they say, oh, hang on, there's a sofa here as well. Or, well, the furniture didn't take off, but here's a phone for sale. Or an Xbox. Or here's a car. Or here's a motorbike. Or here is farming stuff. A lot of farming things go up on the site. So it grew from that. And but it was by pure chance which ones that actually took off. It was definitely not our knowledgeable intelligence, so we were very lucky in it taking off in that way. But our strategy was basically we launch all these different sections to see which ones take off, and then we ride the wave on that and try to make the most out of it.
With the fast pace that the company was experiencing, why did you decide to sell a shareholding in the business?
Well, the site was growing really fast. Everything was hunky dory. But the challenge we had was how do we grow even further? You know, we felt that we were kind of reaching a ceiling here in Ireland. When you have 400,000 people coming to the site every day, you start asking, how many more people can we actually make coming to the website every day in Ireland? Is there more than 400,000 people who are interested in coming to our DoneDeal every day? So that's where the new media group came in, and they started talking to us, and we realized that, hang on, they've grown much, much bigger in a lot of other countries. They run similar websites in 20 other countries. So that's a great resource for knowing where to grow. And it's been a great success. I'm absolutely sure that everyone in the team says the same. Because when we joined in with this media group, it wasn't just that they came in and invested in the business with money and things like that. The big thing was they invested knowledge. So everyone in DoneDeal has now been around to visit their peers in all these other countries to learn about what works in the other countries. Now, in fairness to the media group, they're very good. It's not controlled from the top. A lot of big companies might come in, buy a share in a company, and then they say, well, this has worked in France, now you make it work in Ireland. That's not their strategy. Instead, they say, okay, you guys in Ireland, this thing has worked in France. You go from Ireland to France, talk to the guys in France, check out how it's working, and see if it could work in Ireland. Because just because something works in one country doesn't automatically work in another country. So our people then go over to the other countries, see what they are doing, see what is working, and then they come back with ideas and say, well, geez, they're doing this thing over in France, or they're doing this thing in Sweden, or in China, or in Singapore, or in Chile, and we should do the same. I think it could work in Ireland. Or they come back and they're doing this really amazing thing in Spain, but I don't think it could actually work in Ireland, so we need to look for another idea. And that, to me, is the great benefit of having joined the group, is the knowledge sharing that goes on across the border into all the different countries.
Can you give me one real-life example of a change that has taken place on the website since the new media group have got involved?
We have introduced user accounts. That was a big thing, because when we launched in the beginning, people place their ad, and they could go in and change their ad. That all worked, but there was no place where people could see all their ads. Or even sometimes people remove an ad. For example, if you're selling a motorbike and you don't manage to sell it in the high season, you know, in February, March, April, you might decide to re-advertise it next year. And they couldn't go in and get their photos from last year or re-advertise it and stuff like that, because we didn't have an account. They couldn't come in and see there wasn't one place where you could see all their ads. So just about a month ago or 2 months ago, we launched accounts. So now people can log in, see all their ads in one place, manage them, take them on, take them off, all that kind of stuff. So they can reuse photos from one ad to another. So that has made a huge difference to our users.
Fred, I know that DoneDeal have a huge interest in cause-related marketing. Tell me something about that, please.
We have a big program. We have a program internally for giving money to charity every second month. And I prefer not to think of it as cause-related marketing, because we don't do it really for marketing reasons. We get some kind of marketing out of it, but there's much more than that. We have a program where we donate 10% of our ad revenue every second month to one charity. And this is not about, we get some PR out of this, but it doesn't at all add up to the costs or the donations that we make for this. It's much more about the team feeling. It's about, we obviously get some kind of goodwill. We also get a lot of goodwill, actually, from our customers who see this on the website. So there is a bit of marketing. But to me, the big thing is that the team who are working in DoneDeal, they are the ones who pick the charity of the month. So one person gets designated as the charity picker that month. They pick a charity that lies close to their heart. It has to be a registered charity. That's kind of the rule, but that's it. If that's something local that only really benefits a small local place, brilliant. That's fantastic. If that's what they feel is important, or if it's one of the bigger charities that does work in Africa or internationally or in Ireland or wherever, it doesn't really matter. The important part is one person picks the charity that they feel is their preferred choice. And then we collect the money then from all the ads for one month. And that person then goes up to the charity with a check at the end of the month and hands it over. And that's a great feeling. If you've ever been in a position where we can go into a charity and basically give them a check for, lately now it's about between 30 and 33,000 euros every second month. And if you're the one going to a charity, handing over a check of 33,000, that's a really good feeling. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to make sure that it feels like it comes from that team member. It doesn't come from DoneDeal. It comes because that team member picked the charity. And that, to me, is important. I mean, it gives a whole different team spirit. And I think it also, changing that team spirit internally means that when our team talks to our customers, they talk slightly differently. It changes how people interact with us, because you feel so good about the company. So that's a big part. But then, of course, we get a small bit of PR. We write about it on the blog. We obviously advertise this on the website, so we do get some goodwill. So there is a marketing part of it as well. But to me, it's much more about making sure the team feels part of the community.
Well, Fred, it's a great success story for County Wexford. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for coming in and speaking to us this morning, and I wish you continued success with DoneDeal.
You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Think Wexford Insurances for your business insurance.